Everybody, JC here with another TNI toy review. And for today's review, I'm going to be taking a look at the brand new DCTV 7-inch scale Flash and Arrow figure 2-pack from DC Collectibles. Now this set comes packaged in the same style packaging we've been seeing with all the figures in this line. The figures are clearly displayed in the window box. You've got the Flash and Arrow TV series logos down below, and then off to the side you have the name of the characters. On one side of the packaging you have images of the two figures facing off with each other. And then on the back of the packaging, we have another look at this set, plus some figures, other figures that have been released in the line. Then down below, it tells us the Flash figure was sculpted by Gentle Giant Studios and Steve Kiewis, and the Arrow figure was sculpted by Keith Kopinski. All right, let's get this open and take a look at what's inside. Okay, so here's a look at the figures outside the packaging along with the other contents. So starting with the Flash figure, we get three different pairs of hands. You get a pair of close-fisted hands which are attached to the figure when you first take it out of the packaging. Then you get a pair of just normal open hands. And then you get a pair of open hands that I call like running hands where the fingers are completely straight out. To switch out the hands, you just want to pull off the hand you want to replace, and you've got the little peg on the hand, and you've got the hole on the arm, and then you just plug in the hand you want to replace it with, and you have to kind of push pretty hard, but once you get it to pop in, it'll fit nice and tight. The Flash figure also comes with two different head sculpts. We get an unmasked head and we get a masked head with this figure. And I think the sculpting on these is pretty good. I think the actual faces look pretty true to the actor Grant Gustin. However, I do think the paint applications are a little bit off. I think the skin tone is a little bit pale and the lips, I don't like the color on the lips. Also, he has green eyes. I don't recall him having green eyes in the show. He might, I'm not sure. But for some reason, just like that skin tone, I think throws off the look a little bit. But I think the actual sculpting is pretty true to the actor's likeness. So switching out the heads is easy. You just pull off the head you want to replace and it's attached with the ball joint. Now notice that they included this extra little piece with the unmasked head. It's basically his mask that's supposed to be pulled back and it's done with just a rubber type material. So you just want to remove that when you're putting on the masked head and then that one will just pop right on. And once it does, it fits nice and tight on the figure. Arrow also comes with three different pairs of hands, so you get a pair of close-fisted hands, and these are the ones that are attached to the figure when you first take it out of the packaging. Then you get a pair of hands for holding his bow and arrow, so the left hand is the grip hand for holding the bow, and then the right hand has the two fingers that stick out for pulling back the bow string, and you can stick one of the arrows in between those two fingers if you want. And then we get a pair of third hands, which are more of a just a normal open pair of hands. They do have the two fingers that kind of stick out, so again, you could stick arrows in between those if you wanted to. And switching out the hands once again is pretty easy. You just pull off the hand you want to replace. You got the little peg on the hand and the hole in the arm, and then you just want to plug in the hand you want to replace it with, and it should pop in there nice and tight. The Arrow figure also comes with a bow, and this is the same bow that we saw with the season 3 Arrow figure that we got in this line. You've got the green and the black on the handle, and you've got the little place where you can kind of wedge an arrow in between so to better pose it with, and then it's got the string, the elastic string. And then finally, you get three different arrows with this figure. So you get a standard arrow that's just got a normal arrow head at the top, and that's done with a metallic silver. And then you get these two trick arrows. So this one looks kind of like a smoke arrow. And then this one looks like maybe an explosive arrow. You've got the explosive device, and then you've got the arrow head so it can stick into the wall or something. And all three just have black shafts and then the little green feathers on the end. And as long as you have the proper hands in, you can see he'll hold his bow and arrow nice and tight. So for the figures themselves, starting with the Flash figure, this is essentially the exact same figure that we got previously in this line. Now this new figure is based on the season 2 costume, which essentially means he's got the white symbol as opposed to the red symbol. But the figures themselves are exactly the same. The paint applications are a bit different. The colors are a little bit lighter on this one. And then obviously you get the unmasked head with this new figure as well, which we did not get on the previous figure. But for the actual figures themselves, and including the masked heads, they're exactly the same sculpts. Paint applications are pretty good for the most part. I do have a little blemish on his chin here. You can see a little bit of red that's gotten on his skin tone with the masked head. And then he's got the wash effect with the darker colors throughout. And he's got the little lightning bolts on the side of his head. Now, I hadn't noticed this before, but these little lightning bolts are actually separate pieces. They're not just sculpted, and it feels like they're kind of a rubber material. And you can see this one's got a little bent, but I can kind of move it there with my finger. So just something to note. But overall, nice detailing. And then you've got the texturing throughout. He's got the more smooth leather look on the chest here. But then you've got the texturing for the rest of his upper body. And you've got the gold metallic for the lightning bolts throughout the figure. Again, smooth leather look here. And then you've got the texturing on the hands. His butt's got the leather. And then on the sides of the legs, again, you've got that texturing. And then the lightning bolts. So again, if you have that Season 1 Flash figure, as far as the sculpt goes, you know what to expect with this figure. So for the Arrow figure itself, this is actually my favorite version of the character we've gotten so far in this line. This is the fourth Arrow figure that we've gotten, and I think this is the best one overall. In part, I just like this version of the costume the best over the previous seasons. This is based on the Season 4 Arrow costume, and I like the detailing. I think the head sculpt looks pretty good, pretty true to the actor's likeness. You've got the hood. The hood's attached to the actual figure, and it's done with that kind of vinyl material. So we've seen this with the other figures. So it does limit some of the head movement. Basically, when you turn the head, he ends up looking into the hood. But this one's more open than what we've seen with the previous ones, and it also has some more flexibility. So you can pull it back off the figure's head and reveal the head. And again, I think they've done a pretty good job. Not maybe 100% to the actor's likeness. And maybe out of the four figures, this is the least accurate to the actor's likeness, but still I think it's a pretty good job. He's got the actual green mask on now, and you can see the little straps that go all the way around his head. I think maybe the hair is a little too dark in the actual TV series. I think his hair is a little bit lighter. It's a dark brown, and then they've got some black mixed in for wash effect. He's a little more clean shaven than we've seen with the previous figure, so I like that. And then he's got the outfit with the more leather look, padding and everything. So I like that detailing. You've got the green and then the black mixed in. And then he's got little metallic silver doodads throughout the costume. So I like that. And you've got little texturing on the black portions of the costume. So I like that as well. And then you've got the padding on his shoulder and the wrist guards. He's got the little arrow sculpted on the side of his leg. So I like that detailing. And he's got, I don't know what these are supposed to be, little throwing knives maybe. And then detailing all the way down to the boots. Here does have a working quiver. The quiver is not removable. It's glued to the figure. I like the sculpting detail on it. You got the little arrow sign. Now, I will say that the arrows don't fit that great. They kind of just hang in there. The arrows are a little bit bigger. So I think it would have been better maybe if they had just put arrows in here, like sculpted arrows into the quiver. And I think that would have looked better. But as it is, you can, you know, stick your three arrows that you get with the figure in there, and they'll kind of just sit there. But if you start moving the figure around, they're probably going to bounce out pretty easily. So arrow stands, if you count to the top of his hood, just about 7 inches exactly. And then Flash stands about closer to 6¾ inches tall. Here's a look at all four arrow figures that have been released in this line to date. Here's a comparison of the two Flash figures. Here's a comparison of Flash with the reverse Flash figure. Here's a comparison of Arrow with Malcolm Merlyn. A comparison of Felicity and Diggle with Arrow. A comparison with the two Canary figures. Here's a look at Arrow with Arsenal. Here's a comparison with the new DC Collectibles 7-inch Dawn of Justice Superman and Armored Batman figures. And finally, just for fun, here's a comparison with the Mattel 6-inch Multiverse DCTV Supergirl figure. So articulation on the Flash figure is the same as we saw with the Season 1 Flash. You can turn the head to the left and to the right. He's got a little bit of down movement and back movement, but not too much. You can pivot to the left and right a little bit as well, but again, not too much. Standard ball hinge joint at the shoulder, so he can get his arm out good. He's got good rotation there at the shoulder. He does not have a bicep swivel. Single hinged elbow, so he can bend his elbow about that much. He's got rotation there at the elbow. Swivels at the wrist. Hinges on the hand, so he's got up and down movement with the hands. Then he's got a midsection joint so he can rotate there. He can pivot to the left and to the right. Not much in the way of crunch. He can look back a little bit there. He does not have a waist swivel. Legs are attached with ball joints. He can do the splits about that much. I don't really want to force it anymore. You can do the leg forward about that much, and you can do the leg back pretty good. He does have a thigh swivel, double jointed knees, so good bending there at the knee. He's got a boot cuff swivel, hinges on the feet, so up and down movement, and he does have ankle pivot. He has one peg hole on the bottom of his feet. For the arrow figure, you can turn the head to the left and to the right, and the hood doesn't move with the head, so when you turn the head, he ends up looking into the hood. Also, the head really doesn't have any back and forth movement. Arms attached with your standard ball hinge jointed at the shoulder, so he can get his arm out about that much. He's got good rotation there. He does not have a bicep swivel, only has a single hinged elbow. Unfortunately, it would definitely be nice if they gave him double hinged elbows. He does have rotation at the elbow, swivels at the wrist, hinges on the hand, so he's got up and down movement with the hands. He's got a midsection joint, so he's got rotation there at the midsection. He can crunch down maybe about that much and really can't crunch back. He's got a little bit of pivot to the left and right there as well. No waist swivel. Legs are attached with ball joints, so he can do the splits that much. He can get his leg forward about that much, and he can do his leg back about that much. He does not have a thigh swivel. He does have a double jointed knee, so he can bend his knee about that much. Does not have boot cuff swivel. Hinges on the feet, so up and down movement, and he does have ankle pivot. And then no peg holes on the bottom of the feet for this one. Okay, so that's my review. So overall, I like this set. I like the Flash figure, even though it is just basically a reuse of the Season 1 Flash figure that we got. I like the fact that we get the unmasked head and the masked head. I also like the little pullback mask that they include with the unmasked head. That's a nice touch as well. And then for the Arrow figure, this is my favorite Arrow figure that we've gotten in this line, mainly because I like this outfit the best. Articulation could be a little better on both figures. That's probably the biggest downside with both of them, is they could definitely use a little bit more articulation. But otherwise, I think these are nice looking figures, and if you're a fan of the TV shows, I think these will be ones you want to add to your collection. So this set will be hitting comic and specialty shops this coming Wednesday. They've been out overseas for a couple weeks, but here in the United States, they'll be hitting comic shops right before Christmas. We'll have a full image gallery up at toynewseye.com. There'll be a link in the video description below. As always, leave a comment, let us know what you think. If you're so inclined, please like the video. Also, if you haven't already, please follow me on my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. I'll have links to those in the video description below. And until next time, I'll catch you later.